Get ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Janice Lynde, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Raver.
Why don't you go down and see what the lady wants? Just step right down there and talk to her. And I'll get to you later, lady. There's a very enthusiastic bunch here today, aren't they?
Either that or drunk.
No. Are you all ready to meet our two players there?
Yes. Shall we accept the subpoena from the lady?
No. No, I cannot. I just don't have time. Let's say hello to Sandy Carlisle and Marlene Scott here. Ladies. Now, this lady's our current champ. She's won a total of $1,200, and she's being challenged by Marlene, and they played one game to a tie. It was very tense. And Marlene's had her tie-breaking question. She's matched four of our celebrities, and Sandy will have hers in a moment or so, but right now we want to do this for you. Ready? Now let's reveal our other tie-breaking question, B as it is for Sandy. This is yours. Listen carefully. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Eve said, Adam has broken out in a terrible rash.
Uh-oh. Oh,
I think he must be allergic to blank. Eve is talking about Adam. He's broken out in a terrible rash. I think he must be allergic to blank.
I didn't think she was talking about Cain and Abel.
Hello there.
Oh!
How are you?
Good,
good. How are you?
Splendid, my dear.
I have a question, but I don't think I can ask it.
No. Nope. You're on your own here.
Say it again.
Eve said Adam has broken out in a terrible rash. I think he must be allergic to blank. Okay. Everybody ready in the upper tier?
I've been ready for an hour.
All right. Sandy Carlisle. Eve said Adam has broken out in a terrible rash. I think he must be allergic to...
Fig leaves?
Fig leaves.
Better apples.
What'd you say, Sandy?
It's either that or apples.
Now, the fig leaves, that would hurt, wouldn't it, if he got a rash from the fig leaves? Yes, Joey?
See, a Bible student would remember what it was that Adam ate.
Oh.
In the Garden of Eden, right?
Right.
It was the only thing. Look how the lower tier wants to know what's going on. And I said, apples.
Apples. Are you a biblical student, are you, really? Okay.
Yes, actually, Adam and Eve, when you're talking about them, you're talking about a green pear.
Oh. Oh.
Oh. I don't have to take this for the kind of money they pay on this show.
Right. Leave him alone and walk out. What do you say?
I say, this America, this cough is not terminal, because I get fan mail about my cough.
You do?
Yes, but it's not. I'm not dying. It's just a little... I said fig leaves.
Fig leaves. And Sandy. What did you say, Charles?
I'm sorry, I said apples, too.
Apples, two apples.
Why did you boo him?
Equal time.
Okay.
That's enough. Adam has broken out in a terrible rash. I think he must be allergic to fig leaves, according to Sandy, and she's got to match all three remaining celebrities to stay in the game. Go.
That was my question. I wanted to ask if it was before the snake or after it, so I said apples.
Apples. So Marlene wins the game. Congratulations to you. And you have her on here, and we'll get to you in a moment or so. While we say goodbye to Sandy Carlisle, who's got enough money to fly back to Louisiana, right?
Tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight.
Okay, this very night. It was a great pleasure to meet you. She's got $1,200 and many gifts.
I had a ball.
Goodbye.
Whoops.
Was that on camera? Was that on camera? The door open of the machine there?
Yeah,
I didn't want to expose our inner workings there. Anyway, Marlene, we congratulate you, and if you're ready, we'll go right on here. You know, you can win over $5,000 here. You ready?
I'm ready.
We polled a recent studio audience, my dear. We got their best response to this. Sold blank. Now, that audience, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the answer they came up second most frequently, you get $250, and the third gets you $100. Now, we'll get a little help here from our celebrities.
Richard.
Sold out.
Sold out.
Brett.
Brett.
I hope there was an older group here that day. Sold America.
Sold America, yep. That was an old commercial in radio many years. Sold America. You remember that? You're too young.
No, it said like this.
How'd it go?
May I?
Yes.
Presenting your hit parade.
That's what it was.
He hurt me.
He hurt you.
But with love.
Yes. But with love. Okay, you got two.
Patti.
Hello.
Sold blank. Now, you're a college graduate.
Yes.
And a creative person.
Yes.
You ought to be able to think of something, even though third is tough.
Well, this is for all of Billy Barty's fans. Sold short.
Sold short. Whatever. Okay. So those are the three. Sold short, sold out, and sold American. Now, you can have one of those. You may have a better idea. Something else come in your mind? Whatever you say first will be it.
Sold out.
Sold out. Let's find out if it's up there. We'll begin at the bottom, Marlene. And first, we will reveal the $100 response. Sold to the highest bidder. That's pretty good, isn't it? Okay. We're looking for sold out. Let's see if it's under the $250 number. Sold American. There it is. All right, last chance for sold out. Here's the $500 response. Oh, you got it. Congratulations. Very good. Nice work, Richard. He gave you help there. You had that, too. Well, aren't you happy? You got $600 now, and you're going to play for 10 times $500 or $5,000. Now, to get that amount of money, you've got to match one of our celebrities, and this has to be an exact match. No fooling around here.
Richard.
Okay, Richard, get ready to write. Here we go. You swing around, face me. It's worth $5,000. It goes like this. Basket blank. B-A-S-K-E-T. Basket blank. Now, Marlene, what answer do you want to give us with your ESP going over to Richard that'll match his basket?
Ball.
Ball. Basketball. All right, the audience thinks you may be right. We'll find out if you match him right now. Richard, may we see it?
I'm actually a basket case at this moment.
Really? Why, are you a basket weaver?
No, I shop at a place called...
Market Basket.
No.
No? Basket Market. You're crazy.
We have a ball. Though.
Basket You know who else is happy for you? Come over here. Come over here. Are you rooting for this lady, Earl?
Right on.
Right on, he says. I heard you thumping and banging around in there. Attaboy, everybody loves Marlene because he's got $5,600. We'll get back in a moment or so, but first these messages. Now we're ready to carry on, and to do that, we very happily welcome Mr. Eddie Taylor.
Hey!
Want nobody? Okay. Eddie's going to tell us about Eddie.
Well, I'm a professional bachelor originally from Chicago. And I'm
professional
employed by a major railroad, and I'm a game show fanatic, especially Match Game.
Really?
Yes, sir.
No kidding. You live around here now, or you live in
Yes,
Chicago?
No, I live in Downey.
Oh, you do?
Right, I've been here for 10 years.
How long have you been a professional bachelor? Long time?
All my life.
All your life?
You bet. That's why I'm a
He's
professional.
He's not going to reveal his age, is he?
Say I'm over 35 and under 40.
All right. Eddie Taylor, the best of luck to you. Let's begin. There we go. We got A and B. What do you want?
Let's go for A for all the way.
A for all the way.
I thought he said professional wrestler.
No.
Bachelor?
Bachelor.
When are you going to buy me a hearing aid?
She's failing fast. Must move along now. The network VP said...
Uh-huh. Hi.
Happens to be one in the studio. The network VP said, now that Howard Cosell's show is no longer on the air, we're having his mouth blanked. Now that Howard... You know who Howard Cosell is, Eddie? Now that Howard Cosell's show is no longer on the air, we're having his mouth blanked. The first round questions, you know, are kind of wide open.
That was really a winner, wasn't it? How long was it on? Once?
What's that?
Howard Cosell's show?
He was on a couple of times there, but it really was totally revolting.
Thank you. I was on it.
You were on it. Yeah. Well, you were the only good thing on it.
Oh, okay.
Did you do your imitation? Mm-hmm. I never saw you on it. Okay, everybody ready here and up there. Eddie Taylor. The network VP said, now that Howard Cosell's show is no longer on the air, we're having his mouth blanked.
Bronzed.
Bronzed. Save it for posterity.
I don't care how they applaud it. I gotta say, that's the most stupid answer I've ever heard, but... because I happen to major in stupidity, I have bronzed.
You have bronzed. There's one for Eddie Taylor. What do you say?
That's not stupid. The reason they bronzed it was so he could lock it up and never speak again. Bronze.
Bronze.
Three for Eddie. By the way, he has got another series coming up. It's called Wagon Tongue.
Wagon Tongue.
Oh, you're the one that starts all that booing.
Yes, sir. No.
Wait a moment. When your cockamamie reaction, you go, and they said, oh, she must be right. So they go,
back to your cage.
Joey, I love you, Joey.
Oh, dear.
You also have great grapes.
What do you say, Charles?
I have to move from this floor.
It's nerve-wracking, isn't it?
Well, since the war, I haven't been feeling well. Ron
Zada. The network VP said, now that Howard Cosell's show is no longer on the air, we're having his mouth bronzed, according to Eddie Taylor. What, according to Janice Lynde?
I think it was wishful thinking, but I said sewed shut.
Sewed shut. That's pretty good, isn't it? Yes. What do you say, Richard?
The show is gone, right?
Right.
But his mouth is in reruns.
His mouth is in reruns.
Howard Cosell.
His mouth is in reruns.
I heard it.
You heard it, yeah.
No, I said they had it stuffed.
It's stuffed in... That's a thigh slapper, isn't it? Okay, Eddie, that's not bad for a first-round question, which are usually a little tougher, aren't they, Marlene?
Yes, indeed.
Well, you did very well with yours in that previous game. Let's see how you do now. At the nudist colony formal ball...
Ooh. Oh, that's
you like the way this begins?
Word.
So do I. Fred wore a three-piece outfit. It consisted of... two black socks and a blank. That's at the nudist colony formal.
Oh, I asked for it.
I asked for it. Put it down.
Okay. What is it again?
Nudist colony formal ball. Fred wore a three-piece outfit. It consisted of two black socks and a blank.
Two black socks and a blank.
Formal affair, you said?
Formal ball, yes. Formal affair. Well, three-piece outfit. Two black socks and a blank.
Formal, right?
Well, for black socks, had to be formal. Naturally.
You can play the music louder. It's still the same bad theme. Right. Go with that one.
Okay.
Go with that one.
Joey, put in a slot there.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Marlene.
At the nudist colony formal ball, Fred wore a three-piece outfit. It consisted of two black socks and a...
tie.
Little bow tie there. And two socks, and that's it, eh? Okay, well, it was a nudist camp. Black tie and black socks. Joey, what do you say?
That's what you call good thinking.
Right.
The word formal.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
So I put bow tie.
Bow tie. All right, that's it. Right. Okay. Now, what do you say?
I say there are a couple of other places where they wear black socks. Not
okay.
just Nessus, but I
we
won't
don't care
go...
to explore that subject.
I said a nice black string tie.
Black string tie. Two for you, Marlene. Score it out 3-2, Charles.
I said a small, very small, black bow tie.
Oh. Oh, boy. Score is now tied 3-3 here in the first round. What do you say? What do you say? What do you say?
I thought he would have won a ribbon.
A ribbon?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Pink?
Yeah. Okay. Richard?
Can you explain that answer?
Can I?
Well, see that ribbon there? He would wear a black ribbon.
That's a scarf.
Well, I mean, he
could tie a ribbon into a bow.
And put it around your neck, you see.
Hmm.
Or a tie. Or
no.
Your wrist, like a wrist corsage.
That's right. That's
tie
right.
Tie a yellow ribbon to right. your
cut.
Cut.
Black tie.
Black tie. Four for Marlene. Patty.
Not to mention a very tasteful cummerbund.
A tasteful cummerbund. Right across the middle there, that was very nice.
Very
yes,
funny.
Indeed.
Very good, Pat.
So, there's round one. 4-3 to score. Very interesting game going here. We'll continue it right after this.
Today's consolation prizes are Aristocon, a 12-by-15-foot cushy floor to fight stains, needs no waxing, and only occasionally power buffing. Aristocon by Mannington makes your house beautiful. And a crystal candy dish and Sophie made peanut brittle, the good old-fashioned favorite, and you can still buy it for just peanuts. And cosmetics from Mary Kay for your skincare, including an assortment of Mary Kay creams, lotions, glamour makeup, and men's toiletries. Remember the old saying, still water runs blank. Have some as a guest of Gene Rayburn when Match Game 76 continues in a minute.
Good competitors here, really going at each other. And let's find out how this game ends now as we go to round two. Eddie, it's up to you, A or B?
Stay with A.
A it is. Now, three people do not play.
Just the bottom row. Play.
Oh, just the bottom row. I matched the upper tier in the first row, so this is only for you, bottom row.
Could we have a hand of bridge?
Yes. The bionic woman said, to keep my body running smooth, once a week I go to a gas station and they lube my blank. You've seen the bionic woman? To keep my body running smooth, once a week I go to a gas station and they lube my blank.
Well, girls, get on with it.
That doesn't really make any difference. Lube my...
Wow. That's nice, Janice.
All right, here we go. Eddie? The bionic woman said, to keep my body running smooth, once a week I go to a gas station, and they lube my blank.
Tough choice. Legs.
What?
Legs.
Legs.
Yeah.
What was your second choice?
Boobs. That's a very popular answer on this program. I should...
lube my boob?
Yeah. But the keyword was running, I felt.
Yes,
so.
To keep my body running. Figured the keyword was running, so he said legs.
That's
all
not
right.
That's
yeah.
Good.
No, he logicked it out, didn't he? What do you say?
Well, having not seen this show, which I hate to admit, I just...
Wait a minute. You've never seen this show?
No, the Bionic Woman.
Oh, okay.
That's bad.
Oh! You mean I'm doing that badly, huh? Right. No, I said brain.
Brain. Lube my brain. Keep my body running smooth. Now, what did you say?
Level with us. You haven't seen this show. I said lube the old navel.
Lube the navel. Got to match Patty to stay in the game. What do you say, Patty?
I said lube or lobe.
Lube or lobe. Lube or lobe. So Marlene wins the game. Here we go again. Ready? Okay. We'll get to you in a moment, so. Gotta say goodbye to Eddie Taylor here. Sorry to see you go, sir. We're very happy to have had a game show fanatic on this program. We've never had one before, and we've got a lot of gifts for Eddie Taylor. Together
Thank
with
you.
Our thanks. Goodbye. Now,
we got to do a little business with America here. Is that okay with you?
Sure.
Okay, America. Go to it. Well, listen, we've got to cool it right here. We've run out of time, but those two, or that attractive lady will be back and try for over $5,000 next time we get together.
Marlene.
Wow. Marlene, yes. Marlene Scott was
Dietrich.
Very good. Now, let's see. Just before we go, I want to say Joy Bishop opens at the Sahara in Las Vegas sometimes early in June.
Right.
This lady can be seen, her pretty face and the rest of her body. We just show her face here. On Young and Restless on CBS.
Match Game PM.
Match Game PM, right.
That's
and,
us.
Did you have anything, my dear?
This is where the retired peacock went.
This is where the retired peacock went. Take yes. a deep breath and let's see the whole bird. Okay.
Definitely.
And Charles Nelson Reilly has directed a marvelous Broadway production. Opens, is many.
April 28th on Broadway.
That's a week from, that's 8 days from now.
Yes, it's
or something
finishing
five
in Boston.
Days from now. It's called excited. The Belle of Amherst. Look for it. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game 76. Goodbye.
Ready, look for success. Why?
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76. A Mark Gibson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.